G'day, it's Bill here from OpticsCentral. Today we're having a look inside a Celestron OTA tube, and we're going to put it up on this mount here and tell you about some of the bits and pieces that can come with it and how you're going to option it up. So first thing to do, let's get right into it, because this is, as you know, my favourite bit. As usual, it's a box within a box. Okay, here we are with the inner box, and let's see, there's a telescope tube in there, and there's a couple of little bits and pieces here. We've got, looks like an eyepiece. Yes, it's an eyepiece. We've got, there's a finder scope in this with this one. Actually, I thought that was, that's a bonus. I thought we weren't going to get one. And a diagonal. So, but let's take the tube out. This is the part I really don't like. Oh, that's helpful. You can get those out. Right. Okay, here we have the parts. This is the Celestron C8 with a lens cap on the end, and a visual back with a lens cap, and an area for the finder scope, and don't look at the sun. And this is the Los Mandy sized plate that mates to this mount here. This is an equatorial mount, as you can see. Okay, we'll just pause it while we reset the cameras. Okay, we're back, and we've just moved some things around. Let's start with the scope itself. The scope, the thing I like about the new Celestrons is it's got a handle on it. You can actually just hoik them up fairly easily. It will go onto any of your mounts which has got a dual saddle. This one certainly has, so we can just bang it on like this. I'm not going to bother balancing it because it won't need it just at the moment. We're nice and locked up. Okay. Now the parts that you need to know about with with this guy, I'll just move it so that the camera can see it. How's that? This guy here is what we call a visual back. Now it comes in the box. It comes with it still stuck to it. So that's mainly used as a mount for what you're going to be putting onto it. So the first thing that goes on top of that, I'll just take the cover off. Come here. The first thing you're going to do is put on the star diagonal. Now that came in the box. Now this is a fairly basic diagonal. It just goes straight into there. I'm going to undo these ones because next thing we're going to put in is the eyepiece. The eyepiece is here. And this one is a plessel, and it's a 1.25. Just fold that little guy up. 1.25 inch. The one that comes with the box is a 25 millimeter, and thank goodness it's got a little undercut there, which means that if you don't secure it hard enough, and for some reason you turn it upside down and it drops out, then the thing won't actually fall onto the ground. So now you've got enough. Oh, let's take the lens cap off. I'm looking at the wall at the moment, but now I can see that there's a clear path through. Okay, that is essentially. Oh, one other thing that we need to put on is the finder scope. Now the finder scope is might take me a couple of minutes to put on. It's a little bit fiddly, so I might just stop the camera and get back to you. It goes in here. Okay, here we are. I've just put it in. It goes in from the front. You organise it so that there's a small ring, a small rubber ring that just goes underneath this guy, and then you just twiddle it around with these. Now I've written a blog on how to adjust a finder scope. You'll find it on the OpticsCentral website. This is pretty much the telescope as it comes out of the box. So in the next section, I'll talk about some other stuff that you can put on it. Okay, we're back. The next thing I want to do is show you a couple of different ways that this can be used to drive a camera. Obviously, it's currently in its visual orientation. So the easiest way of taking a photograph through this thing is using the saxon Scope Pix or some similar sort of thing. As you can see, this is it's my mobile phone. It's just my own, and it goes into the saxon Scope Pix so that the lens pokes the little hole there, and you just bang that on there. You just open the jaws a fraction, stick it on there, tighten the jaws down, and hopefully, right, took me a couple of goes, but I've got the saxon Scope Pix on, it clamps onto the end of the eyepiece, and from then you simply just use your camera your phone as a camera, using the normal stuff, and you focus the picture using the normal focus, and you'll get a picture on the screen. Now, this is good for bright objects like the moon. I think it might be good for Jupiter and Saturn. I haven't actually tested that yet. I'll do that at some stage. But yeah, you should be able to get quite a reasonable still picture of the moon. Try using a video, because the movie file that comes out of this you can then put into a piece of software called PIPP, and then from then you can move to stacking. That's a little bit more complicated, but yeah, this is the easiest and cheapest way of getting to astrophotography. Okay, I've just taken the visual stuff off that. The next thing we're going to do is put a digital SLR onto this thing. To do that, we need to have the Celestron T adapter, which is simply a replacement for this visual back. And the thing about it is it's got an M42 thread on the end of the adapter, which means that you can then put a T-ring onto that, and that just hooks straight up to your digital SLR. So we just take this off, put this one on. You notice it's slightly longer. And then we've got a digital SLR here with a T-ring on it, so you can just spin that on there. It's a standard M42 just turn that around, give it a bit of a tighten. And from then on, you just use it as a normal lens. Obviously, you're going to use it on manual and do all of that sort of astrophotography stuff. It will depend on your mount as to how long you can go for, but that's your starting place. Okay. The third way of using your telescope as a camera, or your Celestron as a camera, is by using one of these little guys. This is a CCD, or it's known as an astronomical camera. This one's an Orion Starshoot. It's designed for small objects like planets, rather than big deep sky objects like nebulas. Basically, it's the back end of your digital SLR. It's just the sensor and nothing else. You control it using your computer, and it's got a little cable that hooks in there. Now, it's on a 1.25-inch eyepiece adapter, so where you can put an eyepiece, you can put this guy. So it just slides into the back of the visual back like that. You might need the diagonal to get focus. I'm not entirely sure of that. And here's the cable. The cable is a USB cable, so there's a USB that goes onto your computer, and this one is a USB, I don't know what it's called, a USB-C, I think, but that just goes in there. And from then on, you don't look through the telescope anymore. You do all of your focusing and your framing and stuff like that on the computer screen. So obviously you have to download the software. The software comes on a CD there. So just install it on your computer, and there's a bit of a learning curve, but it works really well. Take it from me, I've done a lot of it. Okay, we're back. The last thing I wanted to show you is a thing that you will probably find is very, very useful if you go out to remote sites or if you get a lot of dew in your house, and it's this thing. This is a dew shield. It's designed specifically for the Celestron 8. The larger ones are bigger. It's really nothing more than a piece of plastic which is cut to the right size, and it goes around the outside of your tube like this. I won't even bother taking the lens cap off. It just goes on like that. It's very, very low tech. Right. I'll just put it on roughly. You can probably adjust it nicely yourself. Basically, what it does is it just prevents dew from falling onto the corrector plate, which will ruin your image. So obviously it's wide enough for it not to impinge on your view, and it's, yeah, like I said, low tech but very reliable. And I think that's really all we've got to talk about with the Celestron 8 that we've got here. So I'll see you later.